Commander you is on after the nomination of various political parties or aspirants has been done. However, some during the adoption process were left out. Among them is Manuel J. Banda, who has now resorted to go solo in Petauke Central constituents in Eastern Province. Now, we also have to understand that Mr. Banda is competing against one veteran politician, a seasoned politician, if I have to make mention that, who is Honorable Doris Leah, and also other four aspiring candidates on the, of course, Patriotic Front. And on the case of Honorable Doris Leah, while Emmanuel J. Banda has gone independent after he was left out from the adoption process. Let's find out what agenda he has for the people of Petauke Central, and of course, what happens if he happened to lose that parliamentary seat. Allow me to make mention further that remember that all the views that might be expressed on this program from our guest does not and will never represent those of Movie Television. But of course, we shall endeavor to ensure that we guide the program to move as smooth as we expect. Thank you so much for joining me, and follow us in the next 30 or 45 minutes to come. Mr. Banda, welcome to the special program.
Thanks a lot. How are you?
I'm fantastic. How have you been?
Hello. Well, and good. As you can see that even just the look.
You're looking terrific, isn't it?
Yeah, and all smart.
Indeed.
Yeah.
Right. How is the constituency?
No, the constituency is okay.
Right.
As you're aware that, I'm sure it is on record, that I started working way back. So I'm sure I did what I could.
Right.
So that come August 12th, I'll carry the day.
Indeed, you've been on the ground from 2016 when you were left out again until now. Sadly, you know, despite that smile on your face, I want to believe that you're a sad person because you were left out from the adoption process and you've decided to go alone. What happened?
Comrade, I'm not sad. As you can see that I'm smiling. Why I'm smiling? Because when I was applying to contest, seeking that adoption to contest the Petauke Central constituency, I knew what I was doing, that I did my groundwork well. So either adoption or no adoption, well, I'm going to carry the day. And I'm sure. And I'm sure it will be the last time for you to call my opponent that heavyweight. She's no longer a heavyweight. Call me heavyweight, not that person.
You claim to be a heavyweight compared to other competitors on the ground.
Yeah.
But of course, one may argue with you to say during the adoption process, you were left out. And that is evidence enough for one to conclude that you are not a heavyweight as you claim.
No, comrade. As of my issue, it's different with other people. My issue, I'll draw you back, I think, in 2018. 2018, when the president came to, that was 2019, when he came to commission Edgar Takwalungu Technical School. I was with my SG. By then, before I resigned, because I'm no longer a member of Patriotic Front, because I resigned, I'm on my own as independent. Yeah. So by then I was a member. So I was standing with him. Then he told me to say, as long as I remain the SG, you'll never become the member of parliament. Because I asked him to say why. He said, you're ugly. So, the Petauke residents, they are the ones who can decide who to send to parliament, not just an individual. So from there, I'm sure it is also on record that there was inter-party elections. Mm. On those inter-party elections, the day I declared that I'm going to stand as the provincial youth chairman, mm. it is on record. The same SG expelled me from the party without any reason. And thank God to the Republican president, Dr. Edgar Chagwalungu, who listens to each and every individual, regardless of who he is. I was reinstated within 48 hours as a member again. And from there, it is also on record, comrade, that the day of a provincial conference to elect provincial leaders for Patriotic Front, I was one of the participants. And when I was, when the conference was about to be opened, it is on record that I was injured and I was taken to hospital. I was admitted. My hand was broken. So from there, I thank my supporters by then. They had negotiated with the doctor to inject me to numb the hand. Then I was given, my hand was put a plaster. Then from there, I went and attended the conference. Well and good, because you know, when you're passing a lot of things, a lot of roadblock, or the day usually before that, I was crying, not knowing that those were tears of joy. Then I carried the day, and the same Secretary General, when he came now to officially declare us as the winner, he started again attacking me to say, it's good that now you're in the structure, so you are a weaker vessel now. I said, look, I'm still coming, yeah. Comrade. I'm still coming.
I know I'll be fast. Let me be quick. Substantiate
okay,
that,
let me be quick.
I want to cut you shortly because I want
let
us to avoid discussing individuals or
okay.
personalities,
okay.
but we discuss
no.
perhaps maybe institutions.
Yeah, yeah, no.
All right?
Okay.
Because what
yes, that's what I'm saying, the Secretary General, I haven't mentioned name,
I'm
saying the Secretary General, comrade.
Yeah. Because, look, those issues you are...
I'm explaining
right
to you
now,
so that you can now...
You are raising right
want,
now here
yeah.
may not be defended
okay,
or
yeah.
may not be,
but I'm,
you know...
I'm explaining to you what happened.
Yeah.
Why it found that I wasn't adopted and
right.
I was ready for
and
that because I was warned.
That's where I'm going.
Yes.
Because really, you can't put a blame on one individual.
Uh-huh.
You understand?
Yeah.
For example, if myself...
Who is the CEO?
Wait,
who is the CEO?
Wait a little bit.
Who is the CEO of the part where I was seeking adoption?
I'm coming to that.
Uh-huh.
If, for example, myself here, I was going to be suspended here,
uh-huh.
of which I've been suspended before.
Yes, who
you
is
understand?
The CEO of
so
the...
So I'll tell you one thing that... If I was going to be suspended here,
yeah.
I think it would be folly for me to only think about the person that has given me that suspension letter, say this is a bad person. You
but
understand?
But
or
he
to
told
attack
me.
The secretary.
But he told
but
me one of
let's
one.
Look at the institution itself. Because
yeah.
whatever decision that are made by
mm-hmm.
movie television
mm-hmm.
is a collective decision.
Yeah.
The same thing like in the Patriotic Front, when they make a decision,
mm-hmm.
and if the SG is going to come out and speak, it's not the SG necessarily,
mm-hmm.
or maybe the spokesperson or whatever,
yeah.
but it's a collective decision.
But
of which the president, I want to believe that will be part of that decision
there's
as a member or in charge of the central.
There is history, comrade.
Mm.
There is history of that. That's why I've told you. I've been following you. I've been telling you
mm.
what happened, because you can't tell me that the Central Committee, when we were standing, when the president came and officiating the Edgar Chagwalungu Technical School,
mm.
I was standing with him. He told me. All the central member of committees were not present there. But it was me, my competitor, and myself, were the three of us. And there was another person who is also a witness, comrade. So I'm talking things which I know, which I was taught.
Right.
Yes, because I can't mislead the masses. I can't mislead the Zambians.
Mm.
I need to tell the truth so that they can know where it
let's
it
talk
missed.
About the entire, you know, institution or governing body, do you think, because they sat together,
yeah.
you know, with the head of state.
Yes, that's what I was coming
so
to that.
Do you think that Really? That decision was done by one person? It was a collective decision?
No. It was done by one person. You know why it was done by one person? Mm. Because they brought in a technical knockout for me to say I was suspended. Mm. So if I'm suspended, then I'm about to appear before Central Committee. Mm. Now, if they adopt me, the same Secretary General said that the Constitution says if someone is suspended and hasn't been cleared by the disciplinary committee, we can't adopt that person, because if tomorrow is adopted and the party decides to expel that member, which means the party won't have any candidate. So that was the technical knockout.
Right.
Yeah.
Let's back
so
the
which was planned by the which was planned by the cartel.
Right. Let's bury the bygones. Let's look at now where you are. You are standing as independent candidate in Pedagogy Central.
Yeah.
You know, but again, on the other side, you made it clear that you are going to support President Edgar Lungu on the presidency.
Yes.
You know, how is your relationship now with the president?
The relationship, I'm the resident of Zambia. I'm the son for Mother Zambia. So the president is the president for everyone. So the president, he can't have any difference with anyone. He's a parent. It's just the same at home. Your kids, even if you send someone to school, then you have left someone, you have started paying for someone, the firstborn, there's the secondborn, you have left that secondborn. It doesn't mean you hate that secondborn, because they're all your children. Yes. So he's our father, he's our president, he's the Republican president of Zambia.
Do you regret having left the Patriotic Front?
I don't.
The political party that you supported for a long time.
I don't. Look now, I don't regret, because I knew it was the plot of the cartel, and it has already started coming out, because now, those cartels now, back where they have gone now to the same adoption which they used manipulation, where they have gone, they failed to work, and then now they are cheating the people. Like yesterday, they were telling Hedmi in our constituents to say, "I'm going to be the running mate in 2026. So if you are refusing to vote for me, then me when I become the Republican president in 2026, I won't help you. I want to hear for your concerns." So now, someone, how can he position herself to be running mate for 2026? But he has failed a constituency. One who has failed a constituency, and then now he's talking about the country. So you can see that she thought people of Petauke, there are people now whom she can take advantage of. Because we are not so that educated. Yeah. So she thought that we can't understand the constitution of Zambia. But we are there. We manage, even if we are struggling to be educated, but we understand the constitution. And we're eligible to anything, because we struggle just to finish school because of the same lack of development. Yeah. The distance. Because primary level, the schools, they're in the radius of 15 kilometer to 20 kilometer. Now, when you're 5 years old, because here I can see, when I go to most of schools here in Lusaka, you find that in most of urban areas, you find that a child who is 5 years old is at school, is in grade one. But come to our village, you find that 5-year-old child, he won't manage to come. It will be just a punishment. Even if he walks, you'll be getting to that school, you'll be tired. That child will be tired, won't even concentrate. So as a result, we are asked now to look after the animals, to be heading animals.
And you feel
until,
I was one of them.
I've hated animals before, because of the distance to the school. Yeah. So if I was sitting again at home, I was going maybe to be a thief. But I avoided to be sitting at home. So I decided now to be herding cattle. So, which also took me about 5 years. So you can imagine, when I was 5, I started herding cattle. Then up to 10 years. Then 10 years now, 12 years, that's when I started the one. So you can imagine, even my tongue was already was already used with the vernacular, with nsenga, chakwasu. Nishiguli ya kosaka nkwasu. Lomba uku anishetiani, lomba unazaka 12. Kutu uchiponzi ile lomba chingerezi. Uchi tetia. So, chonse chila, nichufuwa chate, nchauso goleri. That's why I say, olomba tipitama, mwari ya meni ya na mavuto. Taka mbakuti ya imukwaso. Unoruendo nase, ma qualification itina skulu tisirija. Oro tenzo, punzila ko kanga kanga, tisirija skulu. So, tasirija skulu. Lekani nase kansi mapepa tina, wakufuna aisi zedu, titi, panamire wa ndwampe tauke, tina. So, nga titina, lekani lomba nase, tichita apply. Titua la vonsi. And it was 7 years ago, we no more. If we can't manage to work, we come and do the back in the sagi. Yeah, it is ungozwalini. He want to curate things in parliament, but look, the same thug, the same person who can't articulate things. He has delivered development. I've assisted. I've done like road network. I've done about 200 kilometer gravel. Which I've done across the coast, the constituency. When we look at water, I've done about 130 boreholes. The person who can't articulate the issues in parliament has done those roads, has done boreholes. I've done staff houses for teachers. I've done staff houses for nurses. Have you seen what the thug can do? That's why people of Petauke have said that even if you call this person a thug, even if you call this person uneducated, that's what we want. That's why I'm sure it's evident enough, you can see for yourself, the day I was taking the nomination, the day I was taking the papers for nomination, you saw how people of Petauke, how happy they were. We wanna kukonwela, kwenzeri nivana, kwenza kurakuru, Vantrapulum hote, those are the working as Okanga no tuka, Komaziquanish as the Gambavuti, Uno Wendo Romba, tend to tuke, Wamene welcome out in Sagi, tend to Arangi, Zambia, Yonsevuti, Sagi, Wamene, and you want to fool. Wamene, we also punzir, also as what is Zungu, you want to fool. Wamene, you have no power and to Capano Statin, Wamene, and you want to fool. Mom, Kylie, they have labeled me left, right, center. Try, no, this one is a killer. This one is a thug, this one doesn't know English, he can't articulate things in parliament. But check on my results. My results are fantastic. My results are mwah. Whereby, and it's good that now the levels will change. Immediately when I go to parliament, they will be seeing me, those who are calling me to say I'm uneducated. I'll be at UNSA, University of Zambia. I'll be there.
You seem to be very sure that you're going to get
No, I'm sure.
That I'll get central.
How should I doubt? Check on my opponent. He's sick now. He's every day. Now accusing people. He wants to accuse people to say no. He wants to blindfold people. What are you when you then can have a vice president in 2026. So that voted in. Nishmechi to kukwamuka chwane rini nkangara vice president.
We are going to choose those as...
Watu wana na hivi. So, mpastu. Lekani patu wana kasha. Yeah. Kuli na ingani, wambakari kuna mawandu. Na kwanisha kutuwa na mapepa kuna kwenu. Bize we. Yai, amukani raisi zedi. Enikani laku ni chita kuna kwenu na mapepa na simbo ni pasa. Trakita. Adi trakita, chingwa. Tutoko chama nomination mwamelewa. Achingwa kare uti chuchita tiani. Chugaula, no gaula soti, no mfwiki ila Goliath. Because this fight, it's the fight of David and Goliath, and you saw, and my weapon.
And you are the David.
Yes, I'm the David, and I've got the stones. And that stone, it's those people, the multitudes of people you saw on my nomination. Yeah. So those are the same stone which they are going to bring Goliath down. And I'm sure she knows to say, There's no two ways about it. I'm going.
The PF has made it clear that those that have decided to stand alone, people like you who are going independent, even if you win, the party will not work with you. Because according to the PFSG, I did attend the press briefing, that was yesterday actually, where I mentioned that you betrayed the party, most of you. You know, the Central Committee, chaired by the President, President Edgar Lungu, who is in charge of the Patriotic Front as well, and
Comrade.
Also Republican President,
Comrade.
Chaired that meeting, the Central Committee, and they made a decision to say, Emmanuel J. Banda, among others, you're not going to stand on the PF ticket.
Yeah.
All right,
yeah.
But you decided to go your own way.
Yeah.
On the other hand, again, you claim to be supporting, or you claim to be in love, or to be loyal to President Edgar Lungu, and yet the decision that he made together with other people has been betrayed.
Comrade,
how is your loyalty real?
Comrade,
how genuine?
Before we start talking of my loyalty, comrade, let me remind you. Let me take you back because me, I like. Going through some books about history.
Right.
Yeah, even the Bible. You know, those in the Bible, those names which you hear now in the Bible, they were so much persecuted. And those, after going through that persecution, they became someone. So let me go back in 2016. In Chipiri, in Rwapura province, they adopted the candidate, the PF candidate was adopted. But who carried the day? It's the independent, washed the adopted candidate. But now, the president, that candidate in Chipiri, campaigned for the president. But he washed the candidate. So if that candidate was campaigning for the opposition, would you think the president that would have carried the day? The answer is no, comrade Mkonzi. Answer ni akuti kuti ula candidate wa kuchipiri enze chitira campaign opposition asemba president aliyetole mavoti ya chitola koma romba chichizopezeka kuti ula candidate wenze pereka chipadu then na candidate ulaenze pana mba independent echizo wina ula wenze pa chipani wami wa mkuru enze na ero 2016 Mkonzi. Vintu venze bwino ndo pesa kuti candidate ngati ni minister na chiflaga nacho chiri peru cha campaign chiflaga chiri det chuperuka peruka chiri chimoto kakai ni chipidizero kuti ni vama hala so na chimoto kachulira na security kapokola ali kuvuli koma ka independent ke chizoba nyata mama wa 11 hours aluza munda so lomba ezofuna lomba ta president aluze tingachivomere jeri nicho ero kwasu I'm sure I'm on record. I've been supporting the president. I'm very loyal to the president. To the president, I'm very loyal. That's
the rules have changed. No.
Look, comrade, I'm still coming there.
Those independents, they might have been supported, you know, from 2016 until this year.
Yeah.
But today, the PF has made it clear that they are not going to work with you.
It's the PF. I'm no longer the member of the Patriotic Front.
And of course, we are saying that the president, President Edgar Lungu, is in charge of the Patriotic Front.
Yes, but I resigned from PF, and now let me tell you, I've got a new role.
Right.
I'm the chairman for the foundation, which is Eastern Province for Edgar Chagwarungu and Development. So that foundation, our aim to form that foundation was first to work on the vote turnout in Eastern Province, because Eastern Province, it has been on record, the turnout for 2011, 2015 by-election, and 2016, it has been below 50% voting turnout for Eastern Province. But because of that, I did the research. And after the finding in that research, I said, no, let's form a foundation so that we can boost the voting turnout from 50%, from below 50% to above 90%. So that foundation, I'm sure it has been on record, and you journalists, you have been covering it. You have seen, we moved into all the constituencies. Yes, to talking to people. But I wasn't talking to people on behalf of the party. I was talking to people on behalf of the foundation, which I'm still the chairman.
Right.
And that foundation, it's on record, even you people, the journalists, you covered it. I had the press briefing when the foundation was endorsing the president, Dr. Edgar Chagwarungo. Why we endorsed the president, Dr. Edgar Chagwarungo? Because of the things he has done. But there's a cartel now, those who are saying now, who are talking about 2026 to become the running mate, those are the cartel. Because you can't now start telling people to say, if you won't vote for me, then in 2026, I'll be the running mate for the same party, which I resigned for the same party.
I think for me, the sake of this program, we are going to treat those as rumors for
now. No, it's not rumors.
Let's take them as rumors because
I've got witness.
You've got evidence, but from our side, we don't have evidence. So we'll treat those as rumors.
Okay.
Yeah.
Utiting and koma mwe mama numuja ni kuti wala na kateo. So, amene wala chukwa cha wala kateo, seo tile keri ni mkwa asuna bantu hapo ni mwa kupeta uke na ku Eastern Province Council o ni mwa kuti seo munga chairman wa foundation Eastern Province for Edgar Chagwarungu and Development. Development kuyanga na pachitu kuko, vachita president wasu ha Dr. Edgar Chagwarungu. Ni vinyi njingako. Olopana wera kiala kuno kurusaka. Na dabu wakuti apapanja. Palitara. Museo ogedeza. Chifuku wa kare. Pana nzo wera nukupenza kuti panja panikachoka. Penze rukungu munga kapena nichinji. Kwa malomba, ndi kuta president of excellence. Panja kia pamene pano paino TV. Ah, papa, tete. Palichimuseo chaparulu. Tikariono chuona tete apa nikawina. Pa 12 August. Nikaule tawandu haku peta uke utakawele haka nipele keje kupali ya me. Zika dabu ya misewe hili kuno. Chukwa wandu romba zambu pitila palulu. Kwa makare zenzo pitila pansi. Romba tetu ya vitu kuko. Nye pati ngakange vitu kuko mkwa sifu. No. Those are developments which we want. We also want in peta uke the same development we are seeing vimisewe vo pitila palulu. Na ase upeta uke pa turn off pa papu kwa nikera. Pokondo chitika uozinga. Tingazo kondewa rapane pa kutu pa wenako chimisewe cha palulu pa. Kuti vantu nao vana zikawere zikotamba kana ndachika vechi ndicho cho yamba zikotamba nichimozi in Justin Petauke comrade we have got a technical school that technical school comrade we used just to hear about technical school maybe David Kaunda technical school maybe Hillcrest technical school we never had any technical school but now it's in Petauke Chirimanyama ward which is in the village, Simambumbu village. So all that, what do you want? What do you want if the president can deliver such development? That's why I've said, no. Yes, I'm an independent, but the constitution allows me because I've got a voter's card, comrade. Remember, I've got a voter's card. And then I won't just vote on MP or council chairman and councillor. I need also to vote to choose which president to vote for in August on 12th. I need to vote for a certain president. And I've chosen to say I'll vote for Dr. Edgar Chagwarungu because of the things they have delivered. Look, in Eastern Province, even the whole Zambia, before PF came into power, if any person diagnosed with cancer used to be evacuated abroad, just that person to go and be treated. But right now, right there in Petauke, that's where now if any person who has been diagnosed with cancer is treated right there in Petauke at Karindawaro General Hospital. All that, what more do we want? In Eastern Province, comrade, when you are coming from Chipata, coming to Lusaka, just from Chipata to come to Lusaka, it used to take 7 hours by road before PF came into power. But look now, PF is in power. Driving just from Chipata to Ruangwa, it's about 2 hours. 2 hours and a half. So all that. Miyanu, mwana wa miyanu, waka chite chinji kutimu kamwe. And wamine uyo, rose nukamba kutiba lolesha, mene ya wekamba kuti yae, independent, asakambe para president, ati uje constitution, akakambe cross. Tipunzira romba, orotuzu walinga kwa chizungu, koma tipunzira. Tuwele.
No,
ruku komrade. Tuwele nga so, kulie constitution,
we
kulie
cross. We understand, comrade. We understand.
Wait, I'm still coming, comrade. Right. There's no constitution which says that Tell me the cross, okay, maybe you. Tell me the cross which refused an independent
candidate.
Which refused an independent candidate to endorse the president of his choice.
I want to concur with you, Mr. Banda, you've got your own democratic right to choose which
because even the
candidate
same,
yes. you'd want to support.
Because right. even the same, even the same president
coming
who
on the
voted
morality
for a president.
Aspect, on the morality aspect,
yeah.
to say, like, for example, here at Movie TV, if I'm going to say the Movie Television,
mm-hmm.
Movie TV entire management makes a decision against me, all right?
Mm-hmm.
And then I walk out there to say, I'm not going to support you, for example, maybe
Comrade, wait, Mr.
Tembo.
Yes,
I want to support Mr. Kombi. It means there's a problem in me.
I've got
a choice to choose
yes,
which person
comrade.
I can support at Movie TV.
Okay.
But those decisions were made in a collective agreement.
Look, comrade,
all right?
I've worked before. Look.
I want us to move on.
No. Let me clear you that on that one. Yes, I'm not educated, but I go through a lot of books and I know a lot. That's why I've asked you to say, tell me which...
And
which constitution
to say
the cross?
There is not any
yes, now,
clause in the constitution
yeah, now I'm coming
that denies you to choose your own preferred candidate.
Yes.
All right. But
yeah.
on the moral aspect,
uh-huh.
there is no way where the
now
decision
I'm coming now. So you, if you have differed with, if you have differed with the HR here, can you say that the CEO is not good? I'm asking. If you have differed with the HR here, ula ole mbanchito, ula li nchati, ula accountant, ipokufolesha, akudiera nindala mazonse, mwe mwakalipa, accountant, kwa utakula HR, mpiti kisha ninchito mwe. Muka zonda CEO vena company mwe. Ngatumwe yona CEO mungwa nana, mulipitia la bwino, basu unga wazonde le change. Na uzo uti uwe mundu mwachi pukuku, wazonde le change. Nichimuzina neno. Nidia kangane na president, ha. A president ni mundu wa bwino. Olo kapena vefe nizo ndarende mwana wao nenu wakonda. And the name of Flauta Pitirija, Chukota Jivitu Kukova, and Rosie Bauti, Akumwa Kumunwal once and Kareole Mala, we won. It's on record. Wantrole Mala and Petauke Vaganizira. Come into those who were given mandate to get things from Lusaka, from Minister of Community and Development, to take to the people, those who are not okay, those who don't have legs. So that they can have those wheelchairs. There was no one. It took the same thug which are accusing to say this one is a thug. No, this one is a thief. No, this one is a what? A lot of names. But to me, those are just the Russian. I will apply them. I'll keep on applying them. That's why they won't manage. I'll never give up.
There's one lesson, Mr. Banda, that I think we need to learn from there, more especially we as young people and people like you that are aspiring to take up, you know, the leadership mantle, political.
Yeah.
You know, men have said those that have been in parliament for a long time. You know, the veterans have talked about. They have lectured us to say the people that are standing on the pulpit, more especially the young people like you. Who are claiming that when they go to Manahill, they are going to change things in their constituents overnight. People are saying that is not attainable because when you talk about development, it's not about one individual. It's not about,
comrade.
For example, we had a statement from Honorable Doris Lee, of course, he lectured us. That is a person who has been in parliament for a long time. She didn't mention that.
What has she done? What has she done?
Wait a little bit.
What has she done? Tell me two things. You are a journalist. Look, you are a journalist. Tell me two things which she has done. And don't act on the
expectation. Development is Simon Tumozi. Developing a constituency. If we have chokera ku central government, okay. So if one person is going to stand, in Kalingalinga or Munali Mandevu to say the MP was here, he or she felt
Now let me lecture you on this, on that one now. Which means I'm not going to wear a mukonzi.
Uyo muntu wewera kambati wena kangiwa ni government in general or ni wa president in general. All right.
Yeah.
We also had the same sentiments or similar sentiments coming from Honorable Oliver Peary. Elizabeth Peary. Anakamba ukamba no, the issues in Kanyama don't heap them on one person, but support government in general. But you young people, you seem to be more ambitious.
Akariyo
that's
merenga,
what we have been taught. You're saying you're too ambitious.
Now,
you don't know what is happening in parliament.
Now let me tell you something.
You know,
let me lecture you what happened in parliament.
Please.
Even if I haven't been there, but koma panezo punzira ku sikulu tankhala tenzo punzira pali civics yukamba pali nkhani ya parliament ngangira nkhani ya physics ya civics tipunzira mu parliament vuchitika ni vote yani tuviziva so sati totally jana we that's why kuli mabuku mukwaso. There are books which talks about which they will educate you about how the development is supposed to be delivered. Comrade, let me tell you, do you know that the CDF, Constituent Development Fund, yeah, and that CDF, it's given to each and every constituency here in Zambia. And that CDF, you get it from parliament. So those who are saying that, no, if the MP has failed, which means it's the whole government which has failed. No, they are the same failures. I've given you the example of wheelchairs. Wheelchairs. In Petauke, we had a lot of disability people who had never seen a wheelchair for the past 30 years. But the wheelchair, Minister of Community and Development, they've got in stock thousands of wheelchairs. So you want the president to go and get the wheelchairs from Community and Development to take it to Petauke? Akatole, wherever president evileta, avich twala ku ministry, wherever president akavitole vila puma wheelchair ku ministry kula, akavatwalile vantu ku Petauke. Nchito ya MP ni chinji. Nchito ya minister ni chinji. Upeze wa mine wa wanduwa kupeta uke munga seo. Enze tipasa na uminister. Ministri we tipasa. Icho yamba enso mkwanzi wanikumbusha kitu. Mwane peta uke tudali la paulimi. We depend on farming in peta uke. And it's on record that in 2017 there were army wins. And when we, after election in 2016, the president said, no, peta uke you have delivered enough votes. So I'm going to bless you with the Minister of Agriculture. But in 2017, we had MUNs. But now, since now the MP we had sent to Parliament didn't know about agriculture, where was she? She was in America during the time of MUNs. She was in America watching boxing. Because she, when she was growing up, she was watching that boxing. And say otige itambeko boxing itiwane raomba peti wana MP vaso alikuwa America otamba boxing nene Tyson. Ye peti ziwa boxing. Se fatu ziwa nivauli. So kuti nikalikuza. So lomba. Wait, comrade. So mwe lomba mkakamba kuti yae uli mipala mami we mutilie chite spray. Then tikaze tikatani nilijire wenye uti na president. It's the president who didn't bring medicine to spray the ambulance. No. It's that person who was given that mandate to be the agriculture minister, to be the member of parliament for Petauke Central. Is the one who failed the people of Petauke to bring to spray the amiwe. Kuta tupaye tura to do it. So lomba mwenzofu na uti a president atole lomba the spray vira awele ku Petauke nwamba chita spray minister wechi sanga veve na MP wechi tuma alikuwa America utamba boxe nilo mbazunya tana wandu nje cha mfuna zeni mkamba uti ya kakangiwa MP nishina president akangiwa osa waikako a president kuli vovatete a president waike nkoni kuchitukuko ni muntu wa chitukuko Dr. Edgar Chakwarungu ndiye vuma tumuzivira kwasu ku Petauke ndiye watu muzivira kwasu ku Eastern Province and kuona nkoya ni ku Southern Province atita chinji ni vinyi ndivachita tukanga kwa mene kula kwechi mutana mavoti. Wana ni kulima gesiro, kulima light. Zuta amba pteti pano, zuta amba vonse hivi. Kushoke lera zireka kuwela mchoma. kugayisha zirega kwera mchoma zina vigayo vao pamene kwara kuchinji.
I want us to close Mr. Banda and
no, you journalists, you are the one who is misleading people to say the president doesn't deliver. No, because the MP, if he has failed, which means it's the president. You, from today, you journalists, you should be separating things. Let the failure of the MP be aside, and the development which the president has delivered. Also,
you are being unfair, Mr. Banda.
No, I'm very fair.
We are accusing the
president. No, because you are telling me, you're the same person who is telling me, journalist.
I'm quoting the words from various parliamentarians that were there at that time.
Yes, okay? Because you
informed us.
You publicized it to say no.
Development is not about one person.
Okay, but you know to say.
It's about the government. It's about the central government.
Yeah.
All right? Of which a member of parliament, his or her role is to help it, to enact laws in parliament that are going to help to develop the country in general. All right? Yeah. Not really developing the country. I'm not sure about it. I could be down about it. I could be behind about it.
No.
But a member of parliament is charged with the responsibility to help in acting laws in the parliament.
Who is in charge of CDF?
Of course, the government.
Who is in charge of CDF?
It's the government.
No, who is in charge to get CDF from Mbwani Mukonzi? Who is
Mbwani
Mukonzi?
Even in that CDF.
Niwa ali ofu kotola CDF mu parliament mwa muchinganda cha parliament atole CDF aitwale constituency. Niwa ofu kotitai. Ni member of parliament.
But we've had
Lomba, we've had some
constituencies. There are some constituencies where even when we speak right now, they will tell you to say, the last CDF I got, maybe last year or this year, was supposed to be gotten some 4 years ago. You understand? Even when that CDF is when it's released, it doesn't go in the pocket of a member of parliament.
No, it goes
into
council.
To the council.
But who takes into council? Who takes it in council? And who are the stakeholders in council? It's the MP, the council chairman, or either the mayor, the council, and the, also
we've been
I want to tell you the stakeholders.
As if when that CDF is released, it goes in the pocket of the MP is more like
go,
in charge of,
in charge. He's in charge because he needs to sit with the stakeholders and then to know, to say, this CDF I've come with. You need to sit with councillors, the chiefs, and then you need also to consult the village headman to say, we have received this CDF as a constituents. And then what are the priorities in these constituencies which we can work on? It's either a clinic, either a community school, either bridge, etc.
And let's imagine maybe within a 10 or 5 years, okay, which is that of a member of parliament.
You are
given CDF maybe twice.
No. Boma ya ndika chagwarungu yupasa chaka chiri chonse CDF kuma constituency yonse. That's why even Roneo chairman wa foundation, the Eastern Province for Edgar Chagwarungu foundation. I've endorsed him. Why? It's because of the development. That's why even on the foundation, there's development. Why we have put development? Because we have seen massive development across the country, not just Petauka or Eastern Province. We have been seeing, he has been going all over. Look about men and women in uniform.
I've got a question to that.
You're cutting me, comrade. We are moving now. It's the last point now, so let's move. We'll move. Look about men and women in uniform. Before PF came into power, how was the accommodation? It was a sorry thing. But look now. Ongana vuma upstairs romba. Vila vuma upstairs vizongala mkiala zungu. Tenzo vuanera tiyala muna tikawela murusaka. Tikarutako kapena kukafiwe kwa kuli kensi zedi. Kuli keti zedi. Ndiye kwa tenzo na vuma upstairs. Kwa maromba nkwaya ni paliraya. Kwaya ni nikuni kuli kwa nsemone vuma upstairs. Makapokola romba. Na mwami kumo shuwa ongana romba mchi upstairs. Mwamba munuja president. Osewenza ni? Osewenza. And what was a development because when Kuchoma, Kusouthern province, Kwamene, Kwakamba UTI, or Mufuna Lin, Komanji Kwatwalachi to Kukonu, Apangana Choma and Kara City, Mweo Kari Pia Figariwera Mupawa, Choma and Zepo City, Mweo Mkonzi. Yes, they didn't sit here. So, Vonse Mkonzi, Romba Mundi, what in Galakoya Mika, what it? Wauti, Muchoma, Pangamana City. Why Muchoma, Romba Mone, Vitu Kukovili? Ni mwana nenenji, mwana alirenji, virimu mwana.
We know that Pretoria Central, just like other constituencies in the country, you know, they are lacking behind in terms of development. And if you talk about issues to deal with the...
They are lacking development, they are lacking development.
Exactly.
MPship level coming down, not on the presidential level.
I don't know really how you want to categorize these issues, but... Let's talk about lack of development in general. Uh-huh. Forget about councillor, forget about MP, forget about whatsoever, council chairperson. Let's talk about lack of development. Because when we talk about the roads in Pedauke Central, they are pathetic. Just like
they are not pathetic because I've worked on them.
Just like in other places.
I've worked on them.
I wanted to find out from you, if you were to be voted into power on the 12th of August this year, what could be your first priority agenda or developmental agenda would you want to take the people of Pedauke Central?
Thank you, comrade.
I want us to be quick now. Time is closing.
Thank you, comrade. As for me, my leadership is inclusive. Right. Yeah. So I don't want to impose something on the people of Pedauke Central. Immediate when they bring me into parliament on 12 August, then from there, we'll start the journey of changing Pedauke. First, we need to sit with the stakeholders of Pedauke Central. It's got the church, the traditional leaders, business people, community, Muslim community, Christian community. We'll sit. Then we'll see which projects to prioritize. Those which are very bad, for instance, the radius from the village to the school, which have said that it's about 15 to 20 kilometers. We need also to work on that. Maybe we'll sit as the stakeholders, and then I'll guide them. I'll also remind them about education, because now education is very important. Because even just to be a councillor, I need to be educated. So even me, to be the MP, if I wasn't educated, because there was a rumor, just seeing my vocabulary, they thought that I'm not educated, I don't have a grade 12. But
of course, rumors are everywhere. Yes. Rumors are everywhere, and you can't stop that. You can't stop people from accusing you.
So would you confirm
that... As you stand here tonight, and the people of Pedauke Central that are watching you, and other provinces, would you say you don't have any agenda for now, just for meanwhile?
No,
not
I have
when
agenda.
You go to Manda Hill, then you begin to convene those meetings with the people so that they can tell you what they want.
Look, comrade. I've got already my manifesto. And my manifesto, I started it in 2016, immediately after losing. I never went to sleep. I started now to that's why I've told you to say I've done roads about 200 kilometers. I've done boreholes, water, because water is life. Water is life. I've done about 130 boreholes. Dams. I need to also work on dams, because in Pedauke, thank God, we have been blessed with the Choppies, which is a supermarket now. We never had the supermarket, because maybe when they see JJ, the type of English he's speaking, they say, no, we can't bring Choppies. But now, they have seen now, we are bringing Pedauke Central, we are bringing Pedauke on the map, slowly. So now, look, we have got a supermarket, Choppies. But now, we don't have vegetables in Pedauke. So, immediately JJ comes into parliament, we'll make sure we should have dams, and that dams will help the animals in Pedauke. who also stop getting fish from Lusaka. We'll start farming fish using the same dams. We'll also start farming like gardens using the same dam. So those are the things which we work on.
Right.
And I've already started, there are some dams which was washed away, but I've started also repairing them.
Right.
So those are the things like staff teachers' houses. When you go to some schools, a teacher, you find that he's got a house 10 kilometers away from the school where he's teaching. So you have heard already, I've done also staff teachers' houses. Why? Because of the same distance which they were traveling every day. So you find that a teacher doesn't have a bicycle, doesn't have a car. So for him or her to walk 10 kilometers, then when he gets into class, he starts teaching, you'll be tired. And you know when someone is tired, katempa kuwera pafupi. Uwere mwana gambe kutia umusha tui kamba zisi. Ogamba zi. Zisi zi. Basa mbama mwameni umu. Nishiromba na mwana para mapunziri. Hapunziri yene di. So, chukua chacha menecho ni ambuwa mangira manganda. Lombo ucho katia pafupi. Nganda yupeza tia skulu ni kufuli nganda ilipafuli. Ozi wati ni jeje chita. Those are the things. That's why in Petauke when you said jeje the sad. They were even skin you are right. Try to come to Petauke and say those things you are saying to say the sad. Those things, even these people who are watching me now, I can see there are some who are saying that criminal. Come to Petauke, you say that criminal, you see the way they will skin you are
right. Right.
Yeah.
We've got 5 minutes to closing our program, Mr. Banda.
Yeah.
But allow me to ask you maybe one or two questions before we say our goodbye. We are into the main campaigns now because after the nominations, we expect people like you to now be on the ground, full throat, you know. But on the other side, again, we can't ignore something that has befallen our country. That's the COVID-19 pandemic that began, that was last year, about somewhere there. You know, at a time when we thought that the pandemic is gone, we've been told that another or third wave has come in again, all right? To that effect, we've been advised as a country, again, the Electoral Commission of Zambia has advised people like you, the politician that are wanting to sell your messages to the people, that you have to avoid public gatherings as you convey that message. You know, and a person like you, we have seen... You need to avoid. There's no ban to it. They are advising you to avoid public gatherings. Okay? But people like you, we have seen a huge crowd that you carry each time you go, you know, for these rallies. Another example is that what the crowd that we saw when you were filing your nominations, you know, something that can endanger the lives of people. What is your approach now to that?
Thank you, comrade. Comrade, I'll tell you one thing. Today you can be sick in bed, but when you hear exciting message, you receive exciting message, you even jump from your bed, start dancing, even if you are sick. So those crowds now, that's what happened. When they heard to say, Jeje has taken this bold step, at Tolalomba step, yangu tatipana mire te vandu. Wose kunguera. That's why kwa mpamile pala mwenze mui wana penze na ole mala, tivale shauti ya yosa tamanga, but mwenze pa mene na otamanga. Otamanga, tenze na chifu kwa chakuti, eti mfobu ino. That's why namusha nuti, waloka mbati Jeje ni krimino, Jeje ni chinji, Jeje kuliveve ni mesaya, oyavya, ochita chinji. That's why we want to family param kalangishisha pale papa crowd. Pese na ole ma. Pese ngote. Pense kulukazi. Pense azmai. Pense bantu mayusi wosiana siana. Tenze ti valesha kuti kuli matenda lomba pa kuli matenda. Alesha isi zedi. Koma zili mvuike.
Anti ulomba se
no nukuza gasha. Anti me as a leader now. I had to address them now. There, just outside this is led. to tell them to say, mm-mm, please, as we are going for this election, please, let's avoid this gathering. I know you, my people, you are happy, but please, let's avoid, let's wait so that this wave should go. When this wave pass, then now we'll celebrate nicely. I know on the 12th, because them, that's when I was firing in my nomination. To them, it was already a celebration that we have carried the day. So I told them to say, as we are also coming to celebrate second time now, on the 12th,
right.
Please, let's avoid from now until 12th, so that we should be there, you should witness me.
So you are going to comply to that?
Yes, we are going to comply, and we will never gather. And now also, I'm also asking my fellow participant also to avoid such gathering, also to maintain the rules of COVID-19.
Right.
Because this COVID-19, yes, when we gather, we can say, no, I'm popular, no, I'm what, because of those gathering. But we are killing someone there. Because us, we have felt it before, losing someone. Because in Petauke, that's why some other people, they can call me names. Mm-hmm. But when we cry together. Two little ones in Petauke. Ngatimba chisekele, chisekele la ones. Lomba kine, la lomba.
I want you to answer this question just in a minute, because the allegations, that very strong allegations, that one of the reasons why you were left out from the adoption process was because of your behavior, your questionable behavior, in inverted commas. All right? People are saying you are a person that feels that it's you and yourself. You're uncontrollable. You're a person that doesn't want to heed to any advice, either from your leaders or whatsoever. All what you want to get, you're going to get it. People have cited examples of the issue that you talked about of ambushing police officers, those allegations that you even took in court. You know, have you reflected on those issues and tried to find the modalities on how you can be a better person?
Comrade, in short,
just under a minute, we need to go.
Yes, comrade, in short, in the Bible, what's the history of Saul? Because even you have got history. When you are young, comrade, we can't judge you. When you are young, when you are putting on diapers, when your parents were stopping you to put on diapers, matevera yala, pezo mlesha ni mkonzuti, aposa bwala tevera lomba, usiku la rebuinu. Lomba muna, papa mwakura, tukwa mjajingani uti yae wepa la wenzozi tundira, yae wepa la wenzozi chitajini. Kulie hivyo mkonzi.
So hapa mwakula so, manja sokuli.
Hapa yes, nakula andi vii, lalo mba ni muje ni mkonzi. Yeze, kwenze kusevenza kwa kateo. Amenea wa kateo, eruta mcentral committee no kamba kuti, ya yu ya lipa suspension. But I wasn't serving any suspension. I never had any case. I was cleared by the court. Which means those kateo, they don't trust our courts. Our courts of law. So I'm urging them also to start believing in our court of law, so that in future they shouldn't make the same mistake they made.
Right.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.
So, Mkonzi, I'm a free. Once I'm a criminal, when I'm a criminal, Mkonzi, I shouldn't call you from today. I shouldn't call you to say maybe or speculate or maybe accusing you or maybe to think that you're a criminal, because
no,
I know where criminals stay. I know where Kawala Lapakunga. When Musaburi Ngongala Kawala. Mkonzi kwa tumkaite nye kawala, nye kawala la tili na ipa.
Aso kwa nye mwashita clarify.
Mweni mwuru wala. Mwuru wala. Mwuru wala mwuru wala mwuru wala mwuru wala.
Thank you so much. Time is going to
so be a mind. So the name kakamba ti mweni mwuru wala.
Thank you so much, Mr. Bani. Right. All right, so we end our program here. My guest has been Mano J. Banda, who is aspiring as Member of Parliament for Petauke Central. Thank you so much for watching. Of course, remember, like I did mention the preamble, that the views that have been expressed on this program does not and will never represent those of Movie Television. But we believe that this program has been fruitful. Join us next time. This is Innocent Piri, IP. Good night.